Hi dear children, in the last class we concluded with the term echo. Echo means simply it is the reflection of sound heard after a short interval of time. Today we are going to study about what are the uses of echo. What are the uses of echo? Echo is mainly used for two purposes. Number one, sound ranging. Number two, echo depth sounding. Okay, we are going to study in detail. Can you follow me? For this echo depth sounding and the sound ranging, we are using ultrasonic sound. Do you know what is ultrasonic sound? Ultrasonic sound means the sound or the waves which have ultrasonic waves, the waves which have the frequency of above 20,000 hertz or 20 kilohertz. You know the audio range is 20 hertz to 20,000 hertz or 20 kilohertz. It is the audible range. That means we can hear the sound in between 20 hertz and 20 kilohertz. Here we are saying ultrasonic waves. Ultrasonic waves means the frequency. What do you mean by frequency? Number of vibrations per second. The number of vibrations per second, that is the frequency. Here 20,000 hertz means in 1 second that particular wave, that means ultrasonic wave, vibrate 20,000 times. Can you follow me? Please listen carefully. The meaning of 20,000 hertz means in 1 second that particular wave, here that is the ultrasonic wave, will vibrate 20,000 times. So for sound ranging and echo depth sounding, we are using ultrasonic waves. Can you follow me? Just record and just rewind the topic. Here we are saying echoes are used in the application of sound ranging and echo depth sounding by using ultrasonic waves. Ultrasonic waves have a frequency more than 20,000 hertz or 20 kilohertz. Can you follow me? This ultrasonic wave have some properties. Number one, they can travel in straight line for a long distance. Can you follow me? This ultrasonic wave has some property. It is an energetic wave. It can travel a large distance or it can cover more distance with undeviated. Can you follow me? It travels as a beam. It travels as a beam. It can travel a long distance or far distance, or it can cover a large distance without undeviated. Can you follow me? So we are using this ultra sonic wave. And another property, it cannot easily absorb by the medium. Suppose ultrasonic wave is traveling through a medium. It is not easily absorbed by the medium. Due to these properties, really it is an energetic wave. Due to these properties, this energetic wave can travel a long distance without any deviation. And it travels as a beam, qualified beam. And it cannot be easily absorbed by the medium. Can you follow me? It is an important, what are the properties? It is an important point. What are the properties of ultrasonic wave? Ultrasonic wave means, that means the ultrasonic wave can travel undeviated through a long distance. And they can be confined to a narrow beam. They are not easily absorbed in a medium. We are going to study what is sound ranging in detail. The bats, dolphins, and the fishermen use this property of echo of sound ranging. You know, the bats, while flying, the bats produce ultrasonic waves. This waves travels undeviated long distance. If there is an obstacle or if there is any barrier, this sound is reflected back from that obstacle. By this way, the bats can understand there is a barrier or there is an obstacle or there is a problem. Then the bats can change their path. Can you follow me? Bats produce the wave or ultrasonic waves. This wave travels undeviated. If there is an obstacle, this wave incident on that obstacle, it reflected back and reached. The bats can understand there is an obstacle, then it is also changed. Dolphins also similarly, it will produce the ultrasonic waves. If there is any obstacle or any enemies, this sound or this wave is reflected back. Then dolphin can take precautions or change the path, etc. Similarly, the fishermen, using this sound ranging, there is an ultrasonic sound wave source. Ultrasonic wave source. Okay. Ultrasonic wave source. Suppose the fisherman going in the sea for fishing. They produced this ultrasonic sound or ultrasonic wave from the source. It travels through the sea or the ocean. If there is an obstacle or a group of fishes, a shoal of fishes are there, then this sound is reflected back. We know one equation, V is equal to 2D by P. You know the velocity and you can calculate the time taken to reach back the wave. Then easily we can calculate the distance, how far that obstacle is or how far, how deep that shoal of fishes are there. Can you follow me? Okay, we can study the numericals with this equation. So, simply you have to understand, sound ranging means Ultrasonic wave is produced. It is incident on an obstacle. It is reflected back. Then the barge and load fins can understand there is an obstacle. They can change their path. Okay? That means you have to rewind. You have to listen much more. That means sound ranging. Bats are flying with a speed. Then if there is any obstacle, that sound is reflected back, or by hearing that echo, the bats can change their path. The process of detecting an obstacle is called sound range. Dolphins also detecting their enemies or any obstacle by the similar way or the ultrasonic waves. And the fishermen send ultrasonic waves into the sea and receives the pulse reflected from the shore of fish. By knowing the time and the velocity, they can calculate the distance. Okay. Next, we are going to study sonar. S-O-N-A-R. Sonar. Full form is sound, navigation, and ranging. Sound, navigation, and ranging. Sound navigation and ranging means the waves are sent into the sea water. That means the ultrasonic waves sent into the sea water in all directions from the ship. The waves are received after reflection from an obstacle, or suppose any iceberg, enemy is submarine, or sunken ship, then they can calculate where the obstacle is. Okay? That means we have to learn. Here we are saying sonar, sound, navigation, and ranging. Sonar is used mostly by the our navy. Suppose in the sea or in the ocean, they produce ultrasonic waves. It travels to the whole direction of the sea. If there is an obstacle, or obstacle means there is a big iceberg or enemy submarine or sunken ship, etc., then the waves reflected back. By calculating the time and the velocity of the ultrasonic wave in sea water, it is the velocity of ultrasonic waves is 1400 meters per second. That is the velocity of ultrasonic wave in sea water. That means in 1 second it will travel a distance of 1400 meter. Then by knowing this value and the time, they can calculate. That means when it is produced and when it is reached back. By knowing that time, they can calculate the distance. That is called sonar. Similar type is used in the airports. Radar means radio detection and ranging. The same application is there. That is radio detection and ranging, radar. It is commonly used to control the traffic of aeroplanes in busy airports. Ultrasonic waves are produced. It reaches the obstacles and reflected back. Then we can calculate or we can find out how far this is. Okay? So you can study the uses of echo. To understand the uses of echo, or the uses of echo mainly based on ultrasonic waves. It is one is sound ranging and the depthing. That means we can calculate the echo depth sounding, sound ranging and echo depth sounding. We told the examples of bats, dolphins, then sonar and radar. From this, sonar and radar is very, very important. There is a chance in the board examination for the questions related with the sonar and radar. Okay, study well.